Good morning. I am Kiran Raj. Welcome to the online classes on arithmetic expression, that is Polish notation. Today we will be discussing about how to convert infix expression to postfix expression and some of the recursive algorithm, mainly the Fibonacci series and the factorial of the n. So before going to the algorithm of the conversion from the infix expression to the postfix expression, first let us try to solve the expression so that we can understand the algorithm. Okay. So while coming to here, stacks will be storing the operator and expression P is the output. So when you encounter any operand, directly send that to output, that is expression P. But when you encounter operator, send that to stack, send that to top of the stack. And when you send that to, when you send any operator to the top of the stack, scan or check the precedence of the top of the stack and the scanned symbol. The main point here is, if the top of the stack or the operator which is present at the top of the stack has higher precedence or same precedence as the scanned symbol, then pop the element from the stack. Or I can say like this also, if the scanned symbol has the highest precedence compared to the top of the stack, then you can directly push the elements to the stack. But if the scanned symbol has the same precedence, or if the scanned symbol has lesser precedence compared to the top of the stack, then pop the element from the top of the stack. The second point is, when you encounter open parenthesis, you need not check about the top of the stack or other things. You can directly push that into stack. Third point, when you encounter closing parenthesis, pop every element from the stack until you reach the open parenthesis. Okay? Before that, you have to enter the opening parenthesis to the stack and you have the closing parenthesis at the end of the stack. So what I am encountering here is A, so directly add that to stack, which is an operand. So when you encounter operand, directly send that to expression P. Now I am encountering operator, that is plus. Now, as I already mentioned, they check the top of the stack when the operator is encountered. So when you check the top of the stack, the I'm having the right parenthesis, sorry, opening parenthesis, and my scanned symbol is plus. Okay, so when you encounter this situation, when I am having the open parenthesis, you need not bother about anything. You can directly send the elements to the stack. Okay, so my output is same thing, it has not changed. Okay, now I am going to encounter again the opening parenthesis. As I already mentioned, don't bother about anything, directly send that to stack. Okay, so here again my output is A only. Now I am going to encounter B now. So I'll directly add that to the output. Now I am going to encounter operator. Again check the top of the stack. When you check the top of the stack, again I am going to have the open parenthesis, right? So you need not do anything. You can keep it as such is, and you can add the multiplication symbol. Here also I have no changes. Okay. Then I am going to encounter C now. So directly add that into the output. So it will, I'll have the C now. And stack is no changes in the stack. But now see here, I am going to encounter minus symbol, right? Subtraction symbol. So as I already mentioned, if the scanned symbol has the lower precedence or it has the same precedence compared to the top of the stack, then pop the elements from the top of the stack. Okay? If the scanned symbol has lower precedence or it has the same precedence compared to the top of the stack, then pop the elements from the top of the stack. Okay. So here, I am going to pop multiplication symbol. A, B, C. Okay. Then I am popping out multiplication symbol. Right. So multiplication symbol. Then now multiplication has been popped out. Then what is the, compare it with the open bracket. So you need not bother about it, open bracket, you can directly send the elements, that is minus symbol. Then I am going to have the, again the opening bracket, so need not bother, no changes, just the addition of the opening bracket and no changes in the output also. Now D is coming here, so no changes here. So when the operand is encountered, directly send that into the top of the stack, sorry, to the output. So now I am encountering again division symbol, but what is the top of the stack? The top of the stack is opening bracket, so no need of bothering about anything. You can directly send the division symbol. No changes in the output. Next we are going to encounter E, so directly send that to postfix expression, that is output, so E, and no changes here because I have not encountered any operator. Now, so I am going to encounter power symbol here, so power or cap has the highest precedence, right? So send that directly into the top of the stack. So I should have the cap symbol now. And what about here? It is same thing, right? Then I am going to encounter F. So no changes. Directly I can send that to output. So F is there. Okay. And what about here? Directly same thing, right? No changes. And here, I'll copy this one here so that it will convert for me. Okay, now let us check. What I'm going to encounter here? I'm going to encounter the closing brace, right? Closing brace. That means what? You have to pop every element from the top of the stack until you reach the opening braces, right? So now I will pop every elements in the stack until I reach the top of the stack, sorry, until I reach the opening braces, right? So I'll pop cap first, then the division. Okay, don't make changes there. So which is the top of the stack, that should come out first. Okay, then I have the multiplication has the highest precedence, so no need of making any changes. So I can have the direct multiplication here, sorry. And what about here? No changes. always when you encounter operator, compare it with the top of the stack. If you encounter operand, no changes, directly send that to output. Again, I am going to encounter closing brace here, right? So, what I have to do, I have to pop every element from the stack until I reach the top of the stack. Sorry, until I reach the opening brace. Right? Minus. Okay? What I put here? So, opening brace is also removed. Now, again, multiplication has the highest precedence compared to the top of the stack. Now assume that instead of multiplication I had the minus symbol. Minus symbol and the plus symbol has the same precedence. Then what you have to do? Then you have to pop the top of the stack. So you have to remove the plus symbol from the stack there. Here no changes, right? Then I am going to encounter H here. So directly send that to output. So here no changes. Then I am going to encounter closing braces. So send that to, what I have to do? I have to pop the every elements from the stack until I reach the opening braces. So star, then the plus. So here I am not going to have anything, right? Because I am going to have, it will be empty now. Here I have the algorithm, that is infix to postfix, where q is my original infix expression and p is my postfix expression. So here what I am doing, first I am going to push the opening parenthesis to the top of the stack, and I am going to add the closing parenthesis to the end of my infix expression. So if you see here, I have to add it. Why? I have to add the closing parenthesis. Okay, I have directly added the closing parenthesis here. So you can do that. You can directly add also, no problem. Okay. And here, I am going to scan the infix expression, that is Q, from left side to right side, okay, until my stack becomes empty. If an operand is encountered, then directly add it to the P, that is output, right? But if the left parenthesis is encountered, again directly push that into stack. Now, if an operator is encountered, I have made the symbol for the operator, okay? If the operator is encountered, then repeatedly pop from stack and add to P each operator which has the same precedence or the higher precedence than the R. Only when the top of the stack has the same precedence or the top of the stack has the higher precedence compared to the scanned element or the scanned operator, then you have to pop the elements from the stack. Okay. Afterwards, what you have to do? Afterwards, you have to add the operator to the stack, end of the if structure. Now, what about right parenthesis? When you encounter right parenthesis, what you have to do? You have to pop the every elements from the stack until you reach the opening parenthesis, right? So, what I am doing here? I am popping every elements from the stack and adding it to P until the left parenthesis is encountered. Then what I have to do? I have to remove the left parenthesis. End of if structure, end of the step to loop, exit. So then come to the recursion. What do you mean by recursion? The function or the procedure is calling itself is called as recursion. So recursive procedure and the recursive function. What do you mean by recursive procedure? Suppose P is a procedure containing either a call statement to itself or a call statement to the second procedure, which calls the original procedure. So procedure can call itself, or procedure can call the another procedure which calls back the original procedure. Then we are going to call it as recursive procedure. To be well defined recursive procedure, we should have mainly two basic properties. First one is base criteria, where the procedure will not call itself. And the second property is, each time the procedure calls itself, it must be closer to the base criteria. Recursive function. So recursive function, a function definition refers to itself. So function calling itself is the recursive function. Again, here also two properties. One is basic value, which function does not refer itself, similar to recursive procedure. And the second property, each time the function refer itself, the argument or the value of the function must be closer to the base value, again, which is the same as recursive procedure. Now let us go for the factorial function. What do you mean by factorial function? N factorial, that means n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into n minus 3 into n minus 3 until you reach the 1 there, right? That is factorial function. If I am taking 4 factorial, then what is answer? 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So it will be something like 4 into 3, 12, 12 into 2, 24. So what is 5 factorial? 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which will be 120. Or I can say that 5 factorial is equal to 5 into 4 factorial. Right? So I have done that here. See, n factorial is equal to n into n minus 1 factorial, where n minus 1 factorial is n minus 1 into n minus 2 factorial. Okay, till where you can go? Till you can go till 0 factorial. Why? Because 0 factorial is 1, or 1 factorial is also 1. So here, let us go for the definition of the function. So, what is the basic criteria? You should reach n is equal to 0, right? Because that time only you can have the 1, okay? So, which will be ending the loop there. So, if n is equal to 0, then n factorial is equal to 1, that is 0 factorial is equal to 1. That is the basic criteria, okay? Then how to go there? You have to come closer, right? That means you have to make n minus n minus n minus like that. So, if n is greater than 0, then what is the n factorial? N factorial is equal to n into n minus 1 factorial, where this is calling itself, okay? So let us see the procedure here. Factorial of fact comma n. This procedure calculates the n factorial and returns the value in the fact of n. So what is the first step? That is a basic criteria step. So if n is equal to 0, then set fact, because fact is a result there, okay? So fact is equal to 1, and then you can come out of the program. If that is not the case, then what you have to do? Every time you have to make n into n minus 1, right? So what you are making here? Factorial of fact comma n minus 1. So when I call this one, it is going to come back to the procedure here only, okay? So first it was fact comma 1, n, then it is fact comma n minus 1. In the next iteration, it becomes again smaller, fact comma n minus 2, like that it will become. So set fact is equal to n into fact and return. So this is a Fibonacci series. While coming to the Fibonacci series, f of 0, that is 0 is 0, and the second term, that is f1, will be 1. And the calculation of the third term is the addition of the, or the sum of the previous two terms, correct? and nth term is equal to addition of n minus 1 plus n minus 2. So that will give you the Fn there. Okay. So Fibonacci, Fib, n. So basic condition, n is equal to 0 and n is equal to 1, then f of n, that is it should be suffix, okay, f of n is equal to n there, that is, for example, f of 0 is equal to 0, f of 1 is equal to 1, okay, that is mentioned here. Now, if n is greater than 1, that means n is 2, 3, 4, something like that, then f of 2, n is equal to f of n minus 2 plus f of n minus 1. For example, f of 2 is equal to f of 0 plus f of 1. What is f of 1? 1. What is f of 0? 0. So, 0 plus 1 is 1. That is f of 2. Okay. So, let me do that. If n is equal to 0 or n is equal to 1, then set fib is equal to n and return. If that is not the case, then what you have to do here? You have to calculate two terms, right? One is n minus 2 and another one is n minus 1. So call Fibonacci fib a, comma n minus 2 and fib b n minus 1. Where the result of fib n minus 2 will be present in fib a and the result of n minus 1 will be present in fib b. So you are going to add that fib a plus fib b is equal to fib return. Thank you.